Welcome back to Skippers, presented by Owner's Box Fantasy Sports. Today's segment, must-add pitchers for this week in fantasy baseball. Avery Chenier, Jeremy Roach bringing you some fantasy baseball content. Very exciting news to the channel. 1,000 subscribers. Thank you for everyone who has subscribed. And to give back to our subscribers, we did this on Monday. Mm-hmm. We are doing an MLB jersey giveaway. The rules are going to be down pinned below. So follow those rules. DM us on Instagram with your screenshot that you subscribed. And give back. Let's get a free jersey. Who doesn't want a free jersey? Yeah.
Free jersey. I mean, it's a no-brainer to do. We're growing at a fast rate. It's awesome to see. You guys have been awesome. Our fans have been awesome.
We love the fans. Read all the comments. So thank you for all the nice words as well in the Instagram DMs. It means a lot to us. But we're here for fantasy baseball content. Let's get right into the action.
Yes. I'll start us off here. Must-start pitchers, obviously a new segment that we're rolling out. Must-add players will now just stick to position players. So you guys get more content.
Yeah, more players.
So first guy, we talked about him briefly with Nick, pitchers list, Nick preseason, but that's Mike Minor. And I'm adding him to my must-add pitchers. He's 20% rostered, so he's available in most leagues. I'm mostly picking him up because of his matchups coming up. I'm looking at him right here. Pirates, Cleveland. I would sit him against the White Sox because it seems like the White Sox have been killing pitchers. I know they got Plesac pretty good for two starts. And then he's put Detroit. So 3 out of 4 great matchups for Mike Minor. His velocity is up from last year. But I really want to talk about his curveball. His movement is up on his curveball. He's not throwing it as much.
Movement. Oh, like the spin rate's up. Spin rate's up.
Yes.
So,
yes.
Yeah, okay.
Different movement's up. Yeah. He's got a 33.3 CSW with that curveball, and he's starting to throw it more. It's really optimistic to see that. And I think in the future, he's going to start to throw it even more just because of people haven't been hitting it very well.
All right. One concern I'll give to you, 83% fly ball rate. I mean, he's an extreme fly ball pitcher. He's always been decent pitcher's park, though, out there in Kansas City. So I think Mike Minor's going to be fine.
Yeah, that is an issue just because he doesn't throw that fast. And when you're a fly ball pitcher and you don't throw that fast, that's always scary because the wind's blowing out that day. And
I mean, it's not really a hitter's friendly division for ballparks. So I think it's not. It's just who he is. It's not like really cause for concern because it's not different than any of his other
stuff.
It's
not a different Mike Minor than what we've seen before.
Yeah, exactly. It's the it's the same Mike Minor.
Yeah. And that's pretty much it. I mean, I like his curveball. Like I said, it's something new. I've always looked at, I told you, Abe, I always look for something new with a pitcher. That's something that I really look at when I'm looking to add a pitcher. So Mike Minor, it's my first guy.
Getting to your second guy.
My second guy is Robbie Ray of the Toronto Blue Jays. I really like this pick. I even decided to wear my Blue Jays jersey today. That's how much I like this pick. I was shocked to see that he's actually only owned 34% of the time. I thought he would be higher.
We thought we couldn't use him in this episode.
Because I thought we couldn't use him for this episode. I was surprised just how good he looked against Tampa Bay. I watched that game. His fastball has some life into it. It's come back. He's hit like 97 in that game. That's really good for Robbie Ray. His fastball, everyone was late on the Rays roster. The home run that he gave up was off a curveball, which the Blue Jays broadcast weren't very happy that he threw that curveball.
Noted expert Buck Martinez, eh?
Yes. But no, I mean, he needs to throw his fastball more, and a lot of people have been saying that. He threw it 36% of the time against the Rays. But no, I think that it's got some life into it. Obviously, this is a big strikeout guy. The walk rate is always going to be an issue with him. It's nothing new, but it just, if he can keep it under control, I really do like Robbie Ray. His matchups coming up are not favorable. He's going to be facing the Braves twice, which is just a scary lineup.
Yeah.
I would think Robbie Ray more long term. I'm thinking more long term. This is a guy you start him when he has a good matchup. He's more a long-term guy.
Do you want Steven Matz or do you want Robbie Ray?
Oh, Steven Matz, 100%. But Matz is now upwards of like 70, 80%.
As he should be, yeah.
But I think, 100% Matz. But I think Robbie Ray,
he's got a skill set to succeed, obviously. Mm-hmm. We've seen it before.
He could easily be up to 50, 60% roster with another good start. Yeah. So I would get on him now.
I think you just got to stay healthy. Obviously concerns with the high walk rate, but it's who he is. It's his profile. Mm-hmm. So again, another left-handed pitcher who's continuing to add to his profile. He's already accumulated over his career. So, I mean, not really cause for concern there. Let me get into my guy. First guy, Anthony DeSclafani, San Francisco Giants, 42% rostered. if you look at what the Giants have done this year, actually past couple years, they have taken crappy pitchers who have like, they've kind of flamed out on their other teams. They've come to San Francisco and they've been rejuvenated. I don't know who they're pitching. I should have looked this up. But they've done an absolutely fantastic job. This is another guy from Cincinnati who kind of flamed out. He's like, oh, what are we going to do here? Gets to San Francisco. Great ERA so far. Goes deep into games. Amazing whip. When I look at his fastball, 70% strike rate and a 32.7% CSW that he throws 49% of the time. I mean, this is at 94 miles an hour this year. If you're getting those type of numbers on your fastball, you are going to be successful. Something has to be happening for the hitters to not be swinging or to be swinging and missing on his fastball and to be taking it for a strike. You know, as a hitter, if you don't like what you see, you're going to take it.
Yeah.
So something's happening with his fastball this year that hitters are like deceived by it. He's hiding it well or something like that. And I think that's just an incredible thing for DeSclafani. I mean, that is, I don't know who outs numbers like that on their fastballs. I'm going to look into it and see. I'm sure I'll obviously some of the top guys, but those are really good numbers on a fastball just for a pitch that most hitters think is the easiest pitch to hit because it's coming in at straight. 2-0, 30 innings pitch, 150 ERA, 0.97 whip. I mean, I'm happy with DeSclafani so far.
Yeah, you talked about the Giants rotation. You talked about Johnny Cueto. He was a big ad earlier in the year.
Then you got guys like Aaron Sanchez and Alex Wood now too.
Yeah. Two other guys who have shown life who are on the waiver wire market or picked up. But you know, you talk about the fastball success. He's also had success with that sinker that he's throwing to complement that fastball. But I agree with you. He does look very good, and I think he's definitely a must add. The Giants have been pretty good.
They've been very surprising.
Offense has been really good.
Yeah. I think they brought in their fences last year a little bit to help with some offense there, and it's been good for them ever since. But good little team out there.
Yep.
Next guy, Wade Miley, Cincinnati Reds, 38% rostered. He's been successful by just not giving up anything hard hit at all. Yeah. It's actually incredible. 98th percentile in average exit velocity against, in the 91st percentile in hard hit percentage. He's throwing his cutter 53% of the time, leading to a 54% ground ball rate, which is like, you're going to be successful at a 54% ground ball rate when you're playing at one of the most hitter-friendly parks in the league, a Great American Ballpark. He also complements his fastball, or his cutter, sorry, with a changeup that he throws 32% of the time, which has a 65% ground ball rate and a 33% call strike whiff rate. Those are unreal numbers. Ground ball pitchers can be successful in the MLB. I think they're going away for the, like, a lot of the pitchers nowadays are high fastball, hard cutters. So this is just a whole different way. Below 180 average against, below 180 batting average on balls of play with these two pitches. So far, 2-2, 22 innings pitch. Hasn't been great. Hasn't gone totally deep in games. 2.45 ERA, 0.86 whip. I'm happy with what I'm seeing from Wade Miley in Cincinnati.
Yeah, I mean, Wade Miley kind of reminds me of, in the sense of the not hitting the ball hard off him, is Ryan Yarbrough. Similar type of exit velo against and hard hit percentage.
And they also don't throw the ball too hard.
Yeah. Yarbrough just has that funky delivery that Wade Miley doesn't really have. But you're right. I think in the right matchups, Wade Miley is definitely valuable. And hitter-friendly parks, I worry, just because he throws a lot of strikes.
Yeah.
And he doesn't throw very fast, which
like
is
Mark Burley type pitcher.
And the only thing is that walk rate, 5.8%, and he doesn't throw very fast.
There's nothing wrong with that.
There's nothing wrong with that. His
walk rate's been around 6 to 8 pretty much his whole career. A couple of outliers there. But I think the walk rate is almost not sustainable at 5%.
Yeah.
But if I see him at 7%, I'm like, great year for Wade Miley.
Yeah, I agree.
Any more from you?
No, I think that was good. 4 players.
Yep.
Comment below.
Thank you for tuning in. Enter the giveaway.
Enter the giveaway.
You can get a jersey. Thank you for tuning in, and we will see you guys next time.